Debbie Kay's is a bakery slash coffee shop located in downtown Marquette and founded in 1988. If we do a little bit of a recap of last time's what analysis, we can find the main strengths, weaknesses, opportunity, and threats. Whereas if we go over with the digital marketing plan from last time still, the main goals are to enhance social media presence, maximize website engagement, and lastly, increase customer loyalty. For our target audience, we have mainly friends and families of regular customers, and we split up the audience in two main groups, which are older generation and college students. So this isn't going to be important to consider for the whole presentation. So if we start with our advertising plan, as we all know, the customer loyalty journey has 5 steps, and it advertising focus to bring a customer from a suspect stage to an advocate stage. So when the customer is an advocate of, in this case, Bebby Cakes, he's not only purchasing from Bebby Cakes, he's also recommending the place to other people. And this is really important because as we are here, there is Marquette, there is Northern Michigan University, so there are a lot of college students, and the word of mouth advice is really important in this environment. So we came up with 3 different main ideas for our advertising plan. The first one is a loyalty program, then we have coupons and posters, and then we have emails. So we came up with 3 different loyalty programs that can fit the type of business that Bebby Cakes is in it. The first one is that people can receive 1 point for each of the $5 spent. People would spend money anyway, regardless of the loyalty program, but it is important because by giving them points for the money spent, they get the perception that Bebby Cakes is valuing their money. So it is important. And then once they reach 15 points, they can get a free drink of choice in their next purchase. Another important loyalty program is to bring a friend and both receive a discount. This is important because the loyalty program, the discount can be different every month. So customers can try different products every month and they can spread the voice monthly. So that helps them becoming regular customer, and that helps bring their friends that also can become regular customers of the place. Lastly, we also thought about a 5% discount for all the NMU students, because if they just bring a valid ID to the place, they can just receive a discount. And as I said, this is really important because students are really engaged in online and social media advertising, and so spreading the word throughout those types of platforms is really important and can go really far. Moving on to posters and coupons, there are a lot of places in the universities where you can hang coupons, you can hang posters on campus, so it is important to have that. But in order to also target that other part of audience that are not college students, we thought about hanging, distributing customers just coupons in store when they purchase items. Lastly, we have emails. I'm just gonna briefly talk about it because my teammates aren't gonna be in depth about this, but emails is a traditional advertising technique, but it is important to consider because it has a strong return on investment. So it's definitely something that needs to be implemented in our advertising plan. All
right, now I'm gonna talk about the PR campaign. So overall, Bebby Cakes has already a really good established relationship with the community, so we're just kind of really gonna exemplify on that and kind of retain our image. And our first step in this is in the past couple weeks, we did get new ownership. So our first step is really putting out a press release on this new owner, Chana Edwards. She's worked with the company for around 15 years and she's really prefaced in an interview with TV6 that she wants to get really back to the community and get back into what Bebby Cakes is really all about just from previous ownership. So putting out a press release via email and social media, as that is kind of our main concern right now, is putting more content on social media. This would definitely be a great first step in just getting our feet wet in that. And then going off of that, a little history on her. When she first started, she was a dishwasher at Bebby Cakes, working and living in the Harbor House as well with her 2 teenage daughters. So kind of just honoring her in general, we'd like to partner up a little bit with the Harbor House and over these seasonal months kind of do a donation situation with our customers. So every 3 articles of clothing that a customer brings in, they'll get a 10%, 5% discount towards Bebby Cakes. So kind of just giving back to the community while also retaining those customers with us. Then we'd like to do seasonal flyers. As our company is bakery, they do change their items based on the seasons. So just putting out that content again by email, social media, kind of just letting them know what's changing, anything big, item wise, drinks, food, whatever that may be. Once again, we really want to push content out on our social media platforms, and they haven't been doing that in general, really just food. So kind of putting those events out on that presence is really good for us. Our next step would be collabing with the NMU hockey team, as this is kind of our biggest team in the Marquette area, as well as getting in that college presence in Baby Cakes. Once again, we do have a really good relationship with Marquette, and Marquette has a good relationship with Northern, so kind of just incorporating all of those together. We'd like to set up a little campaign during their hockey off season, where they'll come in, make muffins with us, and then we'll send them out on the town with hopefully our social media coordinator, whatever that may be, and getting that content as well, handing out free samples to the community, getting that word of mouth action, just really trying to send ourselves out there, as Shannon has really talked about this in her interview, just wanting to get back out in the community as we haven't really been seeing that from them as a whole.
Okay, next I'm going to talk about the online and social media plan. So our two main objectives for this is to update and integrate their social media platforms, these being Facebook, Instagram, and then the addition of a TikTok account, and then improving the UX navigation and SEO on their website. Okay, so first off, we're looking to engage various audience segments. Camilla talked about this a little earlier, but we're going to be using Facebook to engage those older audiences, and then TikTok and Instagram for those younger audiences. We're also looking to update their social media platforms to be consistent with Baby Cakes' brand identity. So this includes updating all their account handles to be uniform and the same throughout, which would make it easier for customers to find them online, and then updating their highlight reels to be all consistent, as well as integrating a consistent content calendar with 3 to 4 posts per week. So the content ideas we have, we're participating in trends, employee highlights, pastry highlights, and then highlighting their seasonal menu as well. And then finally, we're looking to hire a social media manager. Currently, the owner runs the account, just to get a little more consistency in there. So currently, this is what their social media looks like, and these were just a few examples of like still images that we'd be looking to add into their feed. Just images of people enjoying coffee in the bakery, and then more behind the scenes as well. So two social media campaigns we're looking to implement. The first one is the Muffin Mania campaign. This would encourage users to share muffin recipes and creative ways to enjoy muffins in the Marquette area. We'd use the branded hashtag BabyCakesMuffinMania for users to participate in the campaign. And then the most innovative and delicious muffin will be recreated by Baby Cakes and sold in store over a 2-day period. It will be featured on our social media accounts, and then the winner would also receive an in-store gift card. And then second is the Coffee and Conversation series. So this would be held on TikTok and Instagram Live. It would be a bi-weekly 30-minute live session to discuss coffee trends and pastries and behind the scenes of the bakery. We could also invite local influencers, customers or staff members to join and share their experiences, and we'd encourage audience interaction through polls and Q&As during those sessions as well. And moving on to the website, this is currently what their website looks like. As I talked about last time, it's just really not cohesive with their brand image at all. And so I just made a little mock-up of like what possibly a website could look like for them. We're really looking to update their website design with UX and a stronger cohesive brand identity. We'd be looking to hire somebody probably in the local area to do this for them, somebody with a little more experience. And then we're looking to also update their online ordering system on the site. So we would have an integrated online ordering system for pickups. And then if the customers wanted their Baby Cakes delivered, there would be a separate button that would take them to the DoorDash service where then they could get that delivered. We're also looking to do keyword research for both social media as well as their website. And then finally, implementing a data tracking service through Google Analytics.
And I'll be going over the timeline. So our plan is set to run for 12 months from January to December 2024. And this will allow the new owner to get comfortable with the business and also let us get the plan going in the winter to be fully optimized by the summer. So be hiring that social media manager. How the social media has been running in the past just hasn't been working, so that needs to change. And we're going to start the search immediately to hopefully have someone hired by January when our plan is set to start. Next, we will be giving out that press release like we talked about earlier. This is just a good form of earned media to really inform the public about those changes, and it's a nice segue into what's to come. And then we'll be getting into website and profile updates along with account creation. This will just lay the online foundation for our plan, and it will also include the redesign of the website, the ordering systems, we'll get the social media profiles consistent, and we'll also be creating the TikTok. Next, we'll begin getting our emails sent out with those newsletters. These will go out seasonally, like we talked about, with the opportunity to become weekly as time goes once we pass the risk of spamming customers at the beginning of our plan with so many other marketing efforts taking place. And then we'll set up our loyalty program. We mentioned a lot of different variations earlier, but whichever one that will be, that system is going to be based on email as well. And then we'll get into creating a content calendar. We're posting normally goes 3 to 4 times a week, and you want to have content planned out at least a month in advance. And then from there, you can really get into posting, especially about those campaigns, events, promotions that we already have some planned, but obviously continuing to add some more. And then lastly, we will be distributing some traditional advertising, so via those posters and also coupons in store. And then all of these steps we hope to have in place by June. This will allow for 6 months to really focus on observations and analytics and making any immediate changes that need to happen so we can have it fully functional by the summer of tours. And I'll also be going over the budget. So when we visited Dan Cates unable to give us any financial information, we have done some research on some nationwide averages of businesses with a similar size and industry. So we have a total budget of $30,000 annually, and we're going to put $20,000 of that towards the social media manager. It'll be a part-time position, and then the remaining $10,000 will go towards the website, the advertising, the